Howdy Bobcats, we have a great show for you this week.
We have a package on an album review written and produced by a student at Sage Creek,
a feature on the new cheer club,
and a recap of the flag football tournament,
and a news update.
Let's roll the intro.
Who's your favorite artist, Hadley?
Taylor Swift, of course. Who's yours?
Billie Eilish. And speaking of music, we have an album review of Sonali Sharma's new album, Before I Go.
Singing it off to Skylar and Makena.
Expression is defined by Merriam-Webster as an act, process, or instance of representing in a media. And for many of all ages, the medium that they express through is music. Sonali Sharma, a junior at Sage Creek, takes this idea to the next level.
I've always really had a love for music and for creating. I think the first song that I made with piano or like with guitar was in sixth grade, and it was probably not very good.
Yeah, she's loved music ever since I can remember. You know, I don't have a single memory of her without, without a guitar or a piano or even just singing out loud about everything. She taught herself guitar, and she's just been attached to music for as long as I can remember.
As of September 2nd, 2024, our very own Bobcat has released her first EP, Before I Go.
These songs have meant so much to me for such a long time, and I kind of realized that I really wanted them to, you know, be really easily accessible to other people so maybe they could have the same impact on them.
All in all, Sonali's goal as an artist is to be able to help people feel something through her music, and she does just that. Each song transporting her listeners within its message.
My favorite song is Remember Me, and I wrote that for my 8th grade graduation. And at the time, it was honestly just a song for me to like help me cope with leaving all these people that I loved and like these places that I really knew behind me. But as I've kind of grown with this song, I've realized that I can apply it in so many different parts of my life.
Listen to Before I Go on all streaming platforms. This has been Makena Coleman and Skylar Roy reporting for The Sage.
Wow, I'm so impressed by her work.
Me too. My favorite song was I Won't Let You Go because I thought the lyrics were really powerful. What was yours?
Remember Me. I love the melody.
Shifting gears to sports, we have an update on our all-new cheer club here at Sage.
Here's Kash and Nixon.
For years, Sage Creek has been the odd one out when it comes to cheer, but a few dedicated students are working to change that. They began this year by starting Cheer Club, a lunch club that teaches passionate students some catchy chants to pump up the crowd at Sage Creek sports events.
Cheer started as a club with a few very interested students. Those students then invited me and Miss Frumenti to sort of advise the club. Then Miss Frumenti and I got Miss B involved, and then we started out as 5 girls at the start of the school year, and now we've sort of skyrocketed and we have 20 girls in cheer club.
Even though cheer has just been introduced at Sage, it has already gained traction as an enjoyable and fulfilling club.
Being in cheer is super fun. We get to work with like our teachers, Ms. Draws, Ms. Frumenti are so amazing at teaching us, and all of the girls are just so fun to work with. And you get to come to these lunch practices and get to go cheer after school and like cheer on your school and just get to work with a bunch of fun girls.
To sign up, reach out to Ms. Draws at brianna.draws@carlsbadusd.net or come to their lunch practices every Thursday in room 2201. This has been Kash Shirvanian and Nixon Ebete reporting for The Sage.
Did you see the new cheer squad at the game on Friday?
Yeah, I hope they cheer for upcoming home games as well.
While the teachers are the quarterbacks in the classroom, who knew they could all play so well on the field?
Take it away, Leila, Cooper, and Grant with the
We made it to the semifinals, and it was honestly really fun. We got a group together of our flag football girls from our actual team, and it was super fun to play. We definitely need to work on our defense a bit, but we made it through a couple games, and the teachers' game was really fun anyways, so it was a good game.
We just played in the final against the students, and because we got MVP Halpert over here, we pulled out that win right there.
You know, at the beginning of the year, I shaved my head so I'd be faster, and I'm just glad that it paid off.
Every
so it feels good.
Bit counts, guys.
Feels good. Every bit counts.
Bit counts.
It's a game of inches.
The first half, it was good. I mean, we started off a little slow. Eventually, we picked it back up. The teachers did play well, but we got tied and we just left it to the other team to, you know, try to secure that victory. So it was all on them. We tried our best.
Second half, started off with a TD, but too many players on the field, so got overturned. But we were never able to come back from that. But we left it all on the field, played our hearts out. That's all that matters.
Looks like the teachers won this year.
So they won this time, but I doubt they'll get it again next year.
I guess you'll have to wait and see. But moving on into news, here's John and Wes.
Hey Bobcats, my name is John and I'll be bringing you news for this week. Tomorrow at lunch there's a National Honor Society meeting. Next week there will be a college visit by UC Santa Barbara on Monday at lunch. Make sure to purchase your tickets for theater's fall production, Shakespeare in Love, from October 3rd to 5th. Tickets are on sale now for $17. Girls Golf has a match against Canyon Crest on Thursday at 2:30. Girls Volleyball has a match today against La Costa Canyon at 6. Girls Field Hockey has a match against Claremont today at 5:30. Girls Field Hockey also has a match tomorrow against Westview at 6:30 p.m. Boys Cross Country has a meet on Saturday at 10 a.m. This has been Wesley Bodensteiner, John Picchi, reporting for The Sage.
That wraps up our show for this week.
Make sure to read all of the articles on thesagenews.com.
And follow us on our socials, Instagram, X, and TikTok, at The Sage Publication. This has been Juliette Delicio.
And Hadley Goins, reporting for The Sage.